Hello guys, welcome to my YouTube channel. And in this particular video, what I'm going to tell you is how we can add a Flutter, we can add a Firebase project to our Flutter application. And as you can see, you can name whatever you want to your Flutter project. And again, upon clicking, it will first take some time to some resource to be allocated, and then it will create our project. So it's just loading. Okay, now the project is ready. Click on continue button. Upon clicking, so in this particular video, I'm going to tell you how we can add Android application to the Flutter project. So first we need to get the name or package name of our application. That's in the Android manifest.xml file. So you need to grab it from here and paste it here. Okay. Now, as you can see, the nickname, app nickname is completely optional, but it's a good practice that you give it there. It totally depend on you, whatever you want to okay, now click on next, and after that process, it will give us a file to download. That file is google-services.json file. This file will help it to uniquely identify a project. Okay, so as you can see, if your case is like me, and if you had downloaded multiple that JSON file, then first you need to rename that file properly, like google-services.json, and we need to put in the right place. And we need to go to the project root directory, and there we need to, under app level build.gradle file, we need to place that file. Okay, so just follow the video. Let me drag and drop it here under build.gradle file. Okay, that again, that I said we need to rename it properly. So this is done. Click on next, and all the things which we need to do after that are thus mentioned here. The thing is, we need to do them in the proper file. First we need to go into the project project level build.gradle file, and then there we need to paste some changes. So let me check whether it is right or not. Yes, it is right. And first, yes, we have that Google function, yes, in the repository, that object, and yes, and it is telling us to, in dependencies, we need to add this line. Okay, copy and paste it here. Again, the things are self-explanatory, but a video that will explain all is a good, and that's why I have come up with this video. Again, in the app level build gradle, yes, we need to do some changes. This app level build.gradle file, just follow the video so that you not fall short or fall into trouble. Then to copy this and paste it just under it. Paste it here. Okay, I think we are good to go, and we have done all the copy paste thing. Yes, so this is just temporary thing. Okay, let me click on next, and yes, you are ready. Yes, now our project is completely linked with this Firebase project. You can click on this button, setting wala button, and it will redirect us here. Again, we need to add some SHA signatures in our application, and this is the part where most people fall into some trouble. And let me show how. First, let me take you all to the documentation. Just click on that question button, and there will be hover see this page link, and here all the commands for particular or specific operating system are there. For Windows, we need to do this. So just click, just copy and paste whatever I am showing in screen. Okay, do this as it is. You can either do it in the separate command prompt, or in the aggregated command prompt as well, terminal as well of the VS Code. Okay, just you have to give the proper direction, and that Anmol is the username of my PC. Again, in the key store password, you need to enter Android ANDROID, and yes, you get your both SHA keys. Guys, please don't use mine, as I will be deleting this project as I will be completing this video capturing. Okay, then you need to add these keys into your project. Both SHA-1 and SHA-256 keys, and voila, your since you added all both your keys, now your project is ready to go. And last you need to do is just close your project and make a hot reload or reinstall the application so that all the things work as fine. I'm just relaunching application here. So after this, you are ready to go to include all the Firebase libraries, like and do all stuff with Firebase. In the future videos, I will be coming with another useful stuffs with the Flutter and Firebase. Hope you like this video, and please give me a subscribe or a like.